By the end of this video, you'll be a pro at graphing linear equations using a table of values. So let's get started. The way we do this, we come up with a value of x, we put that in the equation here, and when we do the math, we get y. Graph the point x and y on a graph paper. So let's put some values in for x. It really doesn't matter what value we put in for x. We just choose some values, but we want them to show up on the graph. So 1, that's always a good option. So when x is 1, put 1 up here, 2 times 1, that's 2, minus 3, negative 1, and we have our first point. 0 is always a good value to put in. So if we put 0, 2 times 0, that's just 0, minus 3, y is minus 3. Then how about negative 1? We have negative 1, 2 times negative 1, that's negative 2, minus 3, we get negative 5. We could have just used 2 points here, and that would still give us a line. But I like to use 3. In that case, if I make an error up here somehow, this will usually catch it. So now we can graph these on our graph paper. X is 1, y is negative 1. So we go 1, negative 1. X is 0, y is negative 3. X is 0, y is negative 3. And finally, we have x is negative 1, y is negative 5. Negative 1, and we go down to negative 5. And you can see they're all lined up. So having 3 of them, I know I've done this correctly. Let's put a line through that. And we put arrows here on the end to show that it goes to infinity. So that's how you graph a linear equation using a table of values. And again, it doesn't matter what values we put in for x. We just want to make sure that the points will show up on our graph. So 1, 0, negative 1, those are usually pretty good points. So pause and give this one a try. Graph the linear equation y equals 4x minus 2. So these are the points that I put in here to find values for y. Then I graph them. And this is the line that I ended up for the linear equation y equals 4x minus 2. You might have used different points, but your line would still have the same slope and y-intercept. Let's try another one. What if you're given a fraction? How do you deal with that? Well, since we can choose any values for x, it's helpful to choose values that'll fit on the graph paper and give us whole numbers. So 1/3 times 3, that would just give me 1. So I'm going to choose 3. 1/3 times 3, that gives me 1. 1 plus 4 is 5. I always like 0. 1/3 times 0, that's 0, plus 4, that's just 4. And then how about negative 3? 1/3 times negative 3, that's negative 1. Negative 1 plus 4, that's 3. Again, we could choose any values for x, but if we're strategic and we end up with whole numbers and it fits on the graph, that makes life a lot easier. Let's graph the points. 3, 5, 0, 4, and negative 3, 3. And there's our line. Let's do one more. So pause and give this one a try. So again, I chose values here for x that I knew would give me whole numbers and fit on my graph paper. So that's how you graph linear equations using a table of values. If you need more help, there's a link at the end of this video to a playlist where you can practice graphing these linear equations using a table of values like we did in this video. This is Dr. B, graphing linear equations using a table of values. Thanks for watching.